Yo guys, what is up? Welcome back to a new video. I tried to film yesterday and it was miserable. Basically, I went to Tesco's, had a chat about the old CV19, went to Tesco's, tried to film some empty shelves, ended up seeing some crazy people doing some crazy stuff, fighting over food and stuff, which is just utterly ridiculous. And then I tried to polish my headlights, took the tint off with the polisher by mistake, so that was a fail. Then I tried to fix my headlights, rung an auto engineer, and basically found out that all I needed to do was change a bulb. So, if you'd like to put up with another video from me, the bodge job of Georges, the Georgiest of bodge jobs, then stick around because I've got lots of stuff to do today. Today is MOT day. Let's see if we can get the baby through the MOT. Now, all the same, be patient. You're gonna enjoy today's video. We'll see you guys shortly. We've got someone coming in a second that will join the video. So stay tuned. As always, G's in the PT, roll the intro. Peace. We've all got that one friend who's ridiculously late, and we also have that one friend who clearly doesn't know how to attach his harnesses properly. But don't give me jip for it, they're going to be attached into a cage at some point. Cauley is always late. He's just turned up and he's down there, so he's coming now. We've got 6 minutes to get there, but luckily the car is up to temperature and it's fast, so we should be okay. I'm also aware this isn't supposed to be like this. It's supposed to be down here. Screw you all. No, I'm kidding. This is a temporary fix, and it is slightly awkward. We've got 5 minutes to get there. Right, guys, we've basically got 3 minutes to get to the MOT garage. Cauley has spent the best part of the last 5 minutes not taking responsibility for being late, haven't you?
Yeah. But, on the other hand,
to start the wagon with the incorrect installed harnesses.
Still work? Still keep the energy?
I completely forgot actually, guys. The extension loom that attaches to the RS back pipe actually broke. So I'm pretty sure that's what pulls up the sensor for saying that, you know, your brake pads are low or something. Now I completely forgot about that. And it's turned out that the car still works and the brakes still work. The custom mods very kindly sent it out to me straight away. So that will be arriving at some point soon.
Oh, you're gonna get past him.
Man, this car's a machine. No tuning spec'd Mark II all day.
Yeah, boy. Better, I need a tune, motherfucker. Have you seen them new cameras as well that they've got on the A3? Little tripod things.
No, why?
They're catching people. Apparently they're supposed to survey traffic on the highway.
Honestly, since the anti-roll bar has gone in on this. Oh, so planted, it just feels so stiff, so good. Yeah, oh, I like that Scooby, that's nice.
What was your run in first, man?
GI autos.
Oh, it's probably that. Oh, that's better. Yeah, I don't know if he's found it or not, but we're parked in the way of everything right now. But yeah, if you guys want to go check out my channel, it's Cauley, C-A-U-L-E-Y. I basically own a BMW 135i. Got a puppy Frenchie. She's like really funny. And I've got a border collie slash kelpie as well. He's like, he's basically a human being. He's actually so funny.
Nice.
Hi, I'm John.
What?
Oh wow, I have braces as well.
Have you done?
Yeah, why not?
What have you fucking done? Waffy, fucking smell it on your fucking face,
mate. Okay, right, little update. We're outside the unnamed, winky winky, unnamed MOT place, and we're getting the MOT done. Everything's fine. I've got the sports car in the car anyway, as I mean, installed in the car, and we're all set, and I put the car back together in such a way that it would be fine anyway. Everything that I had on the car before was MOT legal, but it just saves going through the ordeal of, you know, dealing with people and explaining what things are and blah, 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 blah. So, hopefully, the Focus passes the MOT, and then we can have a little chin wag about the old situation that's going on in the world right now.
Like, I feel like I'm in heaven right now. Look at it. It's so white out here.
Just noticed I've got the standard headlights back in, which
I'm not too happy about. Oh, yeah, boy. Yeah, boy. No, you've just scraped your
good luck.
Yeah, keep going. Keep going. Keep going. Yeah, road number one, emissions test passed. I think we got like a 0.21. So we're on to a winner. But I didn't know, having your car tuned, mapped, pops and bangs or whatever isn't going to make a difference to the MOT per se, but it will potentially fail you. So bear that in mind when getting yours done. We're doing okay so far. Car has passed the emission test, but we do have an ST150 right here. It's actually the first modified car that I bought after I got rid of my 1.2 Renault Twingo. And I'm excited. I'm excited to get this thing through and go carry on with my day. All the boys are down here perving on something. I don't quite know what, but I'm gonna go check it out. Engine in a Vauxhall Corsa. This thing is naughty. Right, Luke. In your opinion, is it going to pass its MOT?
No, shit.
Don't know.
What do you reckon?
Just try it. Nah, it'll be alright.
It's going to be fine.
They're good boys up here.
They're good boys. Matey wants to brake test the car. So we're going to come up very slowly. We're going to scrape so hard.
No, not that way, you idiot.
Yeah, yes, because that's the way we did it before.
Really?
Imagine if I actually cared about my front spare. Always happens. Guess who passed his MOT with zero advisories? George did, in the Focus ST that you guys have been watching for some reason. All the boys have been giving me shit, saying that I'm going to fail, but let's be honest. Fail. Right, now things that they mentioned, I had no advisories. Mate, I'll smash you in that. Can I grab that? Yeah. Right, guys, so things that they mentioned.
You want to go in there, mate?
Tyres are a little bit, not bald, just a little bit worn on the outside edges because when the car, obviously being on callovers, it was a little bit lower. So I guess it was just scraping against the arch, which is fine. Legends. Obviously, because I put my standard ST1 headlights back in, avoided any issues.
You dirty can.
Now, hopefully, Cauley, we can transfer the lights back into the custom headlights.
Yeah.
And it will work perfectly, so that'd be great. But what we're going to do, guys, on the way home, we are going to have a discussion of what is going on
in the world,
in the old media, in the world in general. Genuinely, obesity is preventing me from putting my seatbelt on. It's not even on properly. Guys, like I said in a clip this morning, I am more than aware that it is not supposed to be like this, the harnesses. You know, the roll cage is imminent, as they say. But not more importantly, what is going on in the media right now, referring to my other video, is be vigilant, be careful. Use hand sanitizer and wash and stuff. I mean, in an environment like that, there's a couple of people, you know, there. Ultimately, yes, you are at risk of infection, but something I can do now is go home, change my clothes, wash my hands, wash my face, hand sanitizer, and so on. I don't want to go too in-depth with it, guys. Like I said in the last video, I'm not a scientist, so I don't in any way want to try and steer you to do something that maybe you either did or didn't need to do, all right? So, Cauley, how have your work been dealing with what's been going on at the moment?
Well, they've just cut our days down from 6 to 3, so that's the only thing they're doing.
Okay.
Hand sanitizer, obviously.
Yeah.
And, yeah, just try and, like, we don't use the machine anymore to get people to sign it, because you don't want to pass that germ on just from people, like, scribbling on the machine, so... Other than that, nothing else, really.
Yeah, no, it's probably mad.
Cut off fucking wages.
I think lots of jobs are going to ultimately try and stay in business. That'll be in my foyer.
Oh, nice.
Was that 135?
No.
So jobs are going to try and stay in business, I can imagine, and just make sensible precautions to obviously avoid spread of CV19, you know. Now, in terms of what I'm up to, obviously I live in my own place. I see the two same people all the time, Luke and Cauley. I know that's probably quite risky, probably quite irresponsible in ways, but until the government say, I quote, stay in the house, don't see anyone, I'm not really going to do that. I think if everything were to go to shit, and the world as we know it were no longer the same, I think I would take things a little bit differently. But for the time being, I'm going to put up with... I was trying to explain it to Cauley yesterday. I don't have a cold or a cough or anything. But I suppose it's just that time of year where your nose runs just a little bit. Mm. That's about as far as it's gone to me, certainly for...
That's because it's cold as well.
Feeling any like symptoms. Well, exactly.
Standing in that cold air for too long, your nose is going to run.
We got overtaking us here. Oh, Skoda Octavia.
You little bastard.
Don't worry, these videos will not be boring in days to come. It's just obviously of recent, with what's been going on, it's been important to concentrate on the things that are more important ultimately. And there have been no car shows either, so yeah. Mm. Lots of carbon fibre bits to come. You can see it on my Instagram if you like, actually, but more importantly. So thank you very much for tuning in to today's video. As always, smash a thumbs up on the video, because it hugely helps. Right, seeing as the car's passed its MOT, as bonus footage for the video, does the passenger light now work? I'm hoping for the best. Come on. Come on. Side lights. Full beam. Yeah, boy, I'm so happy. Leave them on. Sick.